it's a quarter to 10 already. I've been up since about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Another short day yesterday. I don't really know what's causing this. Maybe I'm drinking less coffee than I used to. I don't know. I got something to eat yesterday. We talked about that. I got something to eat, and I went over into here, into this here room, and I went to listening to some versions of the track. I determined which one I wanted to use for the vocal mix. I was gonna walk over to the other, back over to the other room over there to do some mixing, and I fell asleep when listening. I didn't really feel all that tired even. I don't know. It's what happens, right? So I woke up today, I did a little bit of listening, and I came to the conclusion that, it's just, the process I was using to determine which one I wanted to pick was I was gonna, sing the song in my head as I was listening and see what sounded good and what didn't. And I quickly came to the conclusion that I was going to have to use the plainest version I possibly could just to sync it, right? The way that I mix it is they all start at the same spot, even if they end at different spots. So if I sync it with the original version, then I can just, delete the bass track. And go from there. So I haven't picked one yet. I'm pretty sure I'm going to use the most complicated version I can. Just because why use one echo when you can use four just to get the effect, right? If I'm doing it for the effect, I want to do it the most absurd as I can, right? So, it's not clear yet, though. Like I say, I'm going to have to sequence the vocals first and then go from there. And as I was listening, I kind of started thinking ahead a little bit, and I did the thing that I've been kind of toying with whether I wanted to do or not. I guess it was about a year ago now, when I unpublished everything. And the reason I unpublished everything was because I wanted to republish it. In such a way that it was in order, it was in sequence, and I would make sure I didn't lose anything. I wasn't sure what the numbers of things were going to be, right? So I didn't want to have to change, 60 releases every time I added a new one, right? So I just took it all down, and I decided, okay, when I'm done, I'll put it all back up again. I think I'm pretty much there. So, I kind of had to come to the, thinking, am I gonna slowly do this? Am I gonna, like, publish a year at a time kind of thing? Like, how am I gonna do this? Sometimes I kind of lose track of kind of what's important in favor of process. Maybe a little OCD in that sense, right? Obviously, I put the music up for people to listen to. And if I don't have the music up, then people can't listen to it, right? let's get out of my head. I like my head. And if you give me the choice, would you rather live in the real world or would you rather live in your head? I think I'll pick up my head, thanks. It's all these things out there. I don't really want to deal with all that. I think I'd rather just stay in, stay in my mind. But sometimes, that kind of bubble, is obscuring, right? And I think that reality kind of jumped up at me. I was like, wait a second. So, am I going to finish all the liner notes from 1999 and then publish 2000 and then finish all the, why not just throw it all out now? So I did that. And I have now published everything right up to 2003. By the time this comes up, I may actually even be done the liner notes for most of it. It's about December 6th. It's the end of... This is the vlog of December 6th, but it's getting to the end of the day. So, this is going to come up sometime in, like, January. January 7th or something. Well, no, I mean, that's when it'll be up, right? So, I very well could be done the bulk of it by then. No joke. Like, for real, right? So, you could very well have the entire list of stuff there to buy, to download, to listen to. Or there might be a little bit left. I don't know. I'm thinking that's about when I'm going to plan to hopefully be done. My birthday's in the first week of January. Can we get this done by my birthday? That would be nice. I'm going to say probably... I'm going to give myself to the spring to be more realistic. There's about 40 releases there. And I mean, I got to finish Boogeyman, and I got to finish the record first. But once I get finished Boogeyman, like, I may add a few mixes that are already done kind of thing to each one that's going to come up. But I really don't expect to be actually adding... Like, I mean, like, there's no mixing to do, there's no recording to do. That huge amount of stuff, like, from 2000 on, it's from early 1999. I mean, I'm jumping ahead right here, because I had already published all the stuff from 1999. But really, it's all of 1999, all of 2000, all of 2001, all of 2002, and the first half of 2003 up until I left... That's where I left off before, right? And I was cleaning up the stuff from period two, and I thought to myself, if we're going to start, yeah, let's take a step back here. When was this? This was in, like, June 2015, so like a year and a half ago, right? I'm about to start the summer of 2015. And I'm closing period two, which is the stuff up to 2003, which was when I left to go to BC, right? I think that the last release there, it is now INRI 69. And that number will probably, well, I know it's going to go up at least one. It'll probably come up more than that. But it's dated to May 1st, 2003. It's the Reflection Symphony, which is now my eighth symphony. So just to get kind of a, you know, the last release that I published was in INRI 19, and it was my second symphony. The one at the end of the list that I just published is in INRI 69, and is my eighth symphony. To get an understanding of the amount of material that just came back up. And I'm going to have to do all the Aleph discs, you know, and are there going to be extra compilations? Like I said, I can think of at least one, which is going to be a vocal compilation sometime in 2000. Sorry, I lost my train of thought there. I'm hungry. I'm just about to... I'm about to stop, get something to eat, and then go over and do my mix for my vocal mix for Boogeyman. Yeah, I think I just wanted to. Wow. Okay. I completely lost my train of thought there. What was I saying? Hoping it'll be done. Yeah, I wanted to. Yeah, okay. So I stopped there in mid-2015, and I said, okay, I'm going to close period two. And then I said, well, can I actually recreate some of the tracks vocally? And I went back and then listened to it and said, yeah, you know what, I can do this. Right? I started remixing it. I didn't think it'd take that long, right? That would take, you know, a couple of weeks. And then I'd have a bunch of... I wanted something called In Reclaimed, and it does come up at the end of my period 1.2 sequence. I was initially going to sequence that at the end of period 2, right? But that, I mean, that took me on the detour, and then I ended up reconstructing all of these new releases, right? And I took it all down because I didn't want to have to renumber everything every time I put a new release up, right? I have renumbered it now. I might have to renumber it a few, probably at least a few more times, but I mean, I'll do it as I go, right? Every time something new comes up, I'll renumber it. In the meantime, that's I've now yeah, so I've now wound myself all the way back to where I was when I stopped. And I think that that's what I wanted to say, was that I wanted to stop. I don't know if I'm hungry or if I need fresh air. It doesn't smell bad in here. So yeah, this is what we're doing here. I'm going to stop. I can't even I can barely talk right now. Just let me. I'm going to stop and start. Yeah, I think I'm just hungry. It's just trying to try to talk into a camera when you're that point of hunger where you're just kind of like is I mean, it's frustrating for everyone, right? You don't want to listen to it. It's maybe a little bit embarrassing on my behalf. That's what I spent the evening doing, was republishing all of it. And that's going to be what I've got in front of me for the next little while, until I get back to where I was. These stories will present themselves. Is what? I don't know exactly yet because I haven't edited all these videos. This is going to be kind of a downside of having such a big gap between when I'm uploading and when I'm editing, as I'm not gonna know when I start a new series until I get there, kind of thing. But this is a good time to start a new series, and in fact, I should probably. Okay, so either we're a few days into season 13, or we're gonna start season 13 now because this is when, Orwell. Or not exactly now, but once I, yeah, actually, that's what I wanted to finish the record and then start the next season, right? But that's what this, whether it starts today or it started a few days ago or it starts a few days from now, that's what this season's focus needs to be on is, okay, the reconstructions are finished, right? The last bunch of seasons have been about. I mean, I wanted it to be done a lot quicker than it was. I called it the Summer of Reconstruction, and I wanted one season to be for reconstructions, and instead I got 3 summers and 2 autumns, right? So I got 5 seasons when I wanted it to be one. But in fact, there's a beginning. There's a beginning this summer, and then there's a summer part one, two, and three, and there's an autumn, and then there's a second autumn. We ended up with a whole Blu-ray disc of reconstructions, or vlogging the reconstructions, right? When I wanted to be done in a month. Is it gonna take me? It better not take me 6 months to write liner notes. I mean, I'm not mixing anything. I'm not like this. This should be quick, right? But this is, we're shifting gears here. I do still have to finish, the vocal mix, and a small amount of. Equalization decisions for the record. I've been pulling this along. I've been dragging it along for like 2 weeks now, 3 weeks maybe even. But I mean, it's just about there. And we are about to pivot to something completely different. No mixing for a little bit. like I said, I'm going to be adding a couple of things. And so there may be some minor mixing. But it's not at all going to be remotely the same. These records, they're mostly done. And in fact, the write-up for most of them is done. A lot of it is just going to be a question of, okay, let's sit down and have a talk about it. We could be doing two or three records a day, although I mean I'd like to maybe, yeah, we can, okay, I'm gonna commit to that right now. No more than one record per day. In which case, or at least to close, I may get ahead of myself a little bit, but as far as the talks go, we're gonna do one per day. At the most. I mean, I've got enough there that I can't imagine that. I'm sure I'll get way beyond, and we'll be going back, and doing catch up. I mean, otherwise, these vlogs are going to be, they're going to start, they're going to collapse under their own weight, because I'm going to be doing, closing three or four records a day, and that's just nuts. In which case, there's what? 50? That's 2 months? 2 seasons? Yeah, this is life. This is how it's going. Okay. What do you say? This is how it's going. Okay, so yeah, that's I'm rambling, but this is what I did for this evening. I republished all this stuff. We're pivoting, and I'm gonna get something to eat. For what it's worth, though, before I get something to eat, this is the my full digital discography. It's available on all of my releases, all my Bandcamp pages, and these are all the ones I did recently, right? So I guess we clued in somewhere right here, right? So that was the end of 2015. That's dated. That's dated December, and that's dated January 3rd, 2016. That's December 31st, right? So these are the releases that we've done over our time together, or at least the new ones that I've added, right? These are the ones that already existed. So that was June 2015. That's my Ambient Works Volume 0. We haven't done that. This is the that's for the closing period two compilation, that one and that one. This is closing the end of period two, and we're still at the end of period two here. That's Rabbit is Wolf stuff, Trivial Group, Rabbit, Trivial, or actually that's J, all the J stuff. Simicide, Rabbit. This is a period that period two doesn't technically close for a little bit, but I stopped there for a reason. I stopped there because when I went to BC, and it was a good spot to make to put in compilations, right? All this other stuff here, and this was all the stuff I did, right? So that's dated to June 2015, right? So that was the last thing I did before. I was working on this before we started the vlog. I had all that gear issues, right? That was the last thing I finished, and it was June. The vlog started in October, so we can see that there was a big gap there, right? And that's May. There was a big gap between December and April because I was working on this track here, which was very time-consuming, right? And there was all this stuff here. Down, right? So it's through 2015 through 2014. Most of it was 2014, right? So their last releases in 2014 were like that. Well, these ones here, they're dated funny because it's when I actually created it rather than when I published it, right? 42 43. That's actually dated to 2003, right? No, it's November. Yeah, this is the last one for... Yeah, because that was Christmas. Okay. Right. Yeah, this is my sixth record. Yeah, this is that's the last record I finished. It's my sixth one. And it's dated to the very end of 2002. But... I published it in May 2015. So this was all early 2015 and 2014, like we start 2014 like here, right? Yeah, we're here. So this is like all 2014 and 2000 and the first part of 2015. So as you can see, I did a lot of work over 2014 and the beginning of 2015, and then, you know, the rug got pulled out of from under me in mid-2015. And I mean, like I say, I'm going to look back on this year and I'm going to say, I didn't do anything this year. But I did do something this year. There's like, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 new ones, right? And then there was a bunch of other ones that I already had up that I'm going to, you know, like tooth again. A huge number of releases dated to this year, right? It's going to look really productive, even though I don't feel like it has been, so it's weird. Very weird. I'll be glad to get over the hump. I'm almost there. It's just, like, to see how much I published, right? It's a huge amount. It's a lot of stuff. A lot of stuff to listen to. And it takes my... Another way to measure it is that... this was at $302 Canadian. A few hours ago, it's now at $568. That's $428 USD. That'll change. The Canadian dollar's going up, so you're losing value. Buy. You're losing value. Buy before the Canadian dollar comes up. You had a chance to buy it cheap. It's your fault, not mine. I'm spending a lot on shipping. You know, I'm sorry. But, yeah. It's there now. It's a lot of liner notes. Like I say, we're shifting gears. And I'm happy we are. It feels good to have that up. But I mean, there's gonna be... I'm just looking at it and I'm thinking, well, I'm gonna add tracks to this one. I'm gonna add tracks to that one. I'm gonna add tracks to that one. That one. Like, I've got a lot of, you know, like, there's going to be mods, but it, broadly speaking, it's mostly done. No writing, you know, there's nothing from scratch, no recording, it's just small mods. I'm hungry, I gotta eat. Well, I just spent a little bit more time in the other room. I got something to eat. And it was like just after 11, and I wanted to take my pills at midnight, so I ended up listening to some songs and screwing around on the internet. But I'm back here now. It's 20 to 1, and let's get this vocal mix done. I have an appointment this afternoon. I'm going to try to stay up all night. I think there's probably a good chance I can get this done. We'll find out. Yeah, it did not take me long to realize why I redid those vocals in the first place. It's just that, I think I went over this once before, but when I redid them, I just recorded them directly into the back of the machine. And I do remember that very distinctly. I remember that was the case because I wanted to, yeah, that's right. If you listen to it, you can hear that, I mixed it back in, so that's kind of circular logic, but I wanted to keep some of the sound effects. And, I actually think I may have, there were little bits that I may have reused, but I remember very distinctly, I recorded it as a WAV file. Actually, no, that's right. I recorded it as a WAV file because I wanted to use Cool Edit to do effects on it. And I think I did. But the result is that I don't have a copy of that second vocal mix that I did. I just have the tape of the original vocal copy, and it's bad. It's awful. I was never a very good singer, although I mean I've sung little ditties on the vlog. I'm not so bad, but I mean at the time I was very clearly tone deaf at the time. And I mean, and I knew at the time I wasn't a very good singer. That's why I was reciting most of the time. But I mean, they're not. I knew even then. I knew they were unusable, and I redid them. So, do I want to do this at all? Or is this kind of silly, really? No, you know what? I'm gonna do it because this is the earliest entry track, right? And I'm coming full circle. This is kind of the last thing I'm doing. I think maybe it's kind of fitting. Yeah. Let's close the circle here. Some people may think it's childish to recite vocals you wrote when you were 12 or 13 at the age of nearly 36. Maybe they're right, but I've acknowledged a few times that this is actually kind of hard for me to let go of, right? I think that maybe this is a little bit of very useful closure. Lock your doors. Keep them shut. Never, ever open them up until daylight. Lock your windows. Lock them tight. The boogeyman only comes out at night. Hey, I've heard worse. Well, I did a fairly quick vocal track, and it sounded good, but, there's far too much noise. So, I'm gonna try it again with, See, it's 2 o'clock in the morning, or 1:45 in the morning, so I don't wanna be howling into the mic. But boogeyman at night. But I'm gonna try another take, see if I can turn the volume up here. I may have to wait until the sun comes up. I told you that yesterday. It might be the case again today. I guess I forgot how to use this. This is a very old microphone here. I actually believe this is from the 30s. An Altec 683B. It's actually, I always say that. I'm trying to talk into the mic and talking to this mic, but I've looked it up a few times and it's actually not that old, but it sure looks old. A radio mic, I believe. I had to see there's some volume. That was the problem, is it didn't have any volume. But had the pans working wrong, but it's working well now, so I think I can get it this time. Okay, so yeah, if I were to sing at this volume, my mic would pick it up. But I'm not singing at this volume, I'm singing at like half of this volume. Right, and it's picking up all kinds of static, so I keep testing it, and it finally dawned on me that, wait, okay, I'm singing far too quietly. I don't really think I have enough control over my voice to kind of get that middle point, right? I'm going to be focusing so much on hitting the right pitch that I'm going to be, you know, so I'm going to wait until the sun comes up before I do this. What that means is I'm going to just close this down. I'm going to work on the other. There was a second. There was kind of a last mix So let me clean that up. And then I suppose I'll get to finishing up the record, because I've got those three little bits. Presuming I'm happy with all the other decisions for the record, and I think I am. I'm sorry, for the single, and I think I am. So let's just put that aside. There's not really much I can do I could probably do it, right? It's just that I don't have the confidence to hit that middle point, right? I can sing quietly, or I can sing loudly, but, and I mean, who knows, maybe when I do it, I'll realize that I can hit that middle point, right? It's just I don't have the confidence in myself to do it without, you know, pissing off, you know, fat-ass, dumb-ass upstairs. So, let's just put it aside, and, hey, don't say I'm not an altruist, right? I hate the guy, and I'm letting him sleep. Alright. Yeah, so we are going to have the session mix on there. I'm not even going to look up the whole ticker thing. I'm not going to bother. If the thought crossed my mind, that's enough to forget about it. I'm just going to call it the fading mix instead. And, my internet's off. Although, you know, I'm going to plug it back in because I'm actually going to, I want to do this in order. So, this is maybe not the most productive night, but let's shut that down. I'm going to get a couple of hours worth of sleep. These short days, I hate the short days, what can I say, but at the same time, it's like, I have an appointment in the afternoon. It would be nice if things had cycled over so that it would make more sense, right? But I can see how it's going to work out, is that I'll, you know, like, fall asleep at, like, if I fall asleep at 9, then I might miss the appointment, right? So it's better to force myself to get a couple of hours for the sleep right now. I don't know why I'm so tired. Maybe I'll get some answers with my blood test. One of the things they tested for was Lyme disease. So they tested me for, they're going to test my hormones, because why not, while I'm doing all the other stuff. They're going to test me for all the STDs, and I don't. I don't think there's a problem. But then again, there's a period I lost, and I don't, you know. I'm going to be surprised. This is a precaution, right? I'm just doing it out of, you know, I'm being safe. I don't expect any STDs to come back. That would suck, right? I'm very safe. I lose 3 hours, and that's when it gets me. Hey, you only have to make one mistake, right? That's what they tell you, and it's the damn truth. Let's hope it's not the case. But the other thing that, and they're going to test for cholesterol and all that kind of stuff, but the other thing is Lyme disease. And I'm kind of starting to convince myself of it. we'll see. I'm only a few hours away. I want to take a shower before I go too, so. Or should I? No, I'm not smoking or anything when I take a shower before I go. Yeah. So, or maybe I could take a shower before I go and when I come back. How about that? Wow. At the very least, I want to get a couple hours. See, now, like, I don't know. I don't know why I'm so tired. I shouldn't be so tired. I'm used to having these long days. Am I like de-nicking? I mean, I actually have not had a cigarette in, like, I mean, like, none at all. And what's the date today? It's the 7th. So it's like what? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, over 3 weeks. I quit smoking like a year ago, but I have been having like a couple of smokes here and there. I haven't had a single cigarette in 3 weeks. So maybe that's it. Maybe my body's like confused. I don't know. Maybe my throat's not feeling so great either, so maybe I'm a little sick. Maybe that's it. I don't know what it is. I know that I'm gonna pass out a little bit, get this uploaded. I got something done today. I would push myself a little harder if it weren't for the vocal thing, right? I'm not gonna do the vocal thing in the morning. I'm gonna get ready to go to the thing in the morning, the doctor in the morning. The vocals when I come back. I think I should make that a priority to make sure I actually do it as soon as I get back. Because then I can close this. It is otherwise done comprehensively. I'm certain of it. But I just gotta finish the part. I think rather than continue ranting, I should just wait until I find out what happens at the doctor.